In this video, I compare recordings made with one microphone with recordings made with two microphones. I recorded four riffs on acoustic guitar. No EQ, no compression, no effects. So you'll be hearing the raw sound as it was captured by the microphones. And as far as treatment goes, I have bass traps and an acoustic blanket on one bare wall. So let's check out the mics. I recorded the mono takes on an SM81. I positioned the SM81 to be about 6 inches from the guitar, pointing to about the 12th fret. Now, there are a number of standard stereo mic setups. For these recordings, I added an NT1 and pointed it towards the bridge area. In order to minimize something called phasing, which could be a whole other topic for another video, I also positioned the NT1 to be about 6 inches from the guitar. Now, there is a rule of thumb for mic separation, and that is to take the distance between the mics and the guitar and multiply that distance by 3. So, 6 times 3 gives us 18 inches of separation. So here are the tracks, and you may want to listen with headphones. I've noticed that audio from PCs, laptops, and smartphones may not be adequate for hearing differences. All right, let's have a listen. As you can hear, stereo and mono recordings give you two different kinds of sounds. You know, and once again, it's kind of up to your preference as to which one you want to work with. For me personally, I kind of like the mono take on the strumming riff and the stereo takes for the finger picking. So comment, like, subscribe, and don't forget to check out the links below. And with that, we'll see you next time.